In this screencast, we will use the Routh Array to determine the ranges of stability for a controlled system. So we have our problem where we have a generic feedback loop which has the transfer functions for the process, the valve, and the sensor transmitter provided below. And our goal here is to find over what range of KC will a P-only controller be stable for this process. Our process is clearly stable right now. The values of tau are 3 and 2 respectively, both positive, and the roots are negative 1/3 and negative 1/2 respectively, indicating that we have a perfectly stable function. The valve with a root of negative 1 is also stable. So right now our process is stable. If tuned incorrectly, a controller can make a stable process unstable. So what we want to do now is determine over what range of KC will this happen, or from the other side, where will it be stable, so we know what range of values we can potentially utilize. So there are a number of different ways in which this can be analyzed, but for the sake of this analysis, we're going to use a Routh array. And a Routh array requires the use of the characteristic equation. And remember, the characteristic equation is of the form 1 plus the open loop gain equals 0. In a generic feedback control loop, like one we're going to look at this problem, this generic feedback control loop consists of the controller, the process, the valve, and the sensor transmitter. And this characteristic equation equals 0. So we'll now substitute in these values. It is a P-only controller, so GC will be KC. The process transfer function will be what we see above. The valve transfer function is 2 over S plus 1, and the transfer function is 0.5. So therefore, we set that equal to 0. What we now need to do is get a least common denominator so we can assess this. So our least common denominator here will be 3S plus 1 times 2S plus 1 times S plus 1. Only the second term has a denominator. So therefore, for the 1, our denominator will now reappear in the numerator because that will be the 1 over 1 term. And then if we look at our second term, we have KC times 4 times 2 times 0.5 in the numerator. So this will just become 4 times KC. And this all equals 0. The denominator goes away. So what we now need to do is expand out to the first term. So you can do this any way that you see fit. Here, we'll multiply the first two terms together. So we'll have 6s squared plus 5s plus 1 times s plus 1 plus the 4kc that's coming down. This will equal 0, again, to finish the factorization. So now we have this set up all ready to be analyzed in the Routh array. Recall that for a Routh array, for the process to be stable, we need to have two things happen. One is that all of the coefficients must be greater than or equal to 0, and two, all the terms in the first column of the array must be positive. So if we look at our terms here, the 6, the 11, and the 6 in the cube squared and first powered s's respectively, they're always going to be positive. But we do have a criteria here where 1 plus 4kc must be greater than 0. So in this case here, KC is going to have to be greater than negative 1/4. But we're going to use the array to further fine-tune the evaluation of our gain, because both of these facts must hold in order to have a stable process. So on the screen, we have now put on the relevant information that we need to solve for the Routh array. First, we'll fill in the values of our coefficients. So we'll start with our AN value, which here N is 3, because the power of S is 3, so it'll be 6. An minus 1 corresponds to the second power, or 11. An minus 2 corresponds to the first power, or 6. And an minus 3 corresponds to the constant, which is 1 plus 4kc. So using this information, we can solve. So for B1, we have an minus 1 being 11, which will appear in the numerator and the denominator. An minus 2 is 6, just as an is 6. And a sub n minus 3, the constant, is 1 plus 4kc. So for B1, what we're left with is 60 minus 24kc over 11. For B2, we don't have enough coefficients in our characteristic equation, so therefore, an minus 4 and an minus 5 are both 0. Therefore, B2 is 0. So what this means is that the only other constant we have to take a look at is C1. And what we see here for C1 is that B2 is 0, meaning that the second term goes to 0. then the B1s cancel with what's left, and all you're left with is AN minus 3, which is 1 plus 4KC. And what we have here for the stability assessment is the exact same thing we had for the analysis of the equation, such that 1 plus 4KC had to be greater than 0. So this KC is greater than negative 1/4 is still our value of interest, but this is going to be affected now by B1 also having to be greater than 0. So here we need 60 minus 24KC over 11 to be greater than 0. The 11 will go away, and what this will lead us to after some math is that KC has to be less than 2.5. So we know that in order to satisfy both the original equation in C1, KC has to be greater than negative 1/4. But we also know that in order for our process to satisfy B1 being positive, KC must be less than 2.5. So therefore, the system is stable when KC is in between negative 1/4 and 2.5. Thus, by picking a value outside this range, what you'll have done is you will have turned a perfectly stable process unstable. So in this screencast, we used a mathematical technique known as a Routh Array to determine the range of stability for a controller, or in other words, what are the possible controller values we have to conduct our control operation.